the subject.
Senator Seward.
Thank you, Mr. Acting Deputy President. I arise to talk yet again on sharks in Western Australia and the appalling cull program that is currently being undertaken in my home state. Over summer in Western Australia, we have had two very large protests in Western Australia about the state government's shark catch and cull program. The latest I had pleasure in joining on the 1st of February was over 6,000 Western Australians on the beautiful Cottesloe Beach, and they were in fact joined by thousands of people around the world that were protesting to protect our sharks, something the West Australian government and the federal government will not do. These people gathered to express their disappointment and anger at Premier Barnett's approach to shark management in Western Australia, and also the complicity of the federal Abbott government in the culling of this protected species, the great white shark, but also its impact on other sharks, such as tiger sharks and bull sharks, and also other marine life. The West Australian government's catch and kill policy is a knee-jerk policy reaction to a perceived increase in risk of shark attack. It lacks the backing of science. In fact, it's been criticised across the planet for its lack of science, and it has not been subject to adequate scrutiny at a state or federal level. And it should be ended immediately. The exemption to this policy should be revoked, and the policy should be abandoned. Over the past few weeks, drumlines, and they're visible from shore. You go to any beach in Perth now, the main beaches in Perth, and you can see these the buoys for the drumlines just off the beach. These drumlines have been installed along the West Australian coast, including off Perth's most popular beaches. The reports to this date, and I've got to say here that the state government is refusing to release information about the impact of this appalling policy, and it's left up to the community. And in fact, Surf Life Saving Western Australia is also reporting through tweets. And so it's left up to the community to report and us to pull together figures. So far, we're aware that 4 sharks greater than 3 metres have been slaughtered. 6, we understand, have died from being caught on the line and have become drowned or injured, and in fact been attacked by other sharks or predators while they've been on the hook. There are at least 26 sharks of less than 3 metres in length that have been released. Some of these, we understand, are injured, and we don't know what has been the fate of these sharks that are under 3 metres that have been caught. One shark has just been reported, or one shark of under 1 metre in length has been reported to have died, been attacked on the hooks. And this is despite the Barnett government's pledge that the hooks would be too big to catch smaller sharks. The state government is in breach of the undertakings and conditions, undertakings it gave to the federal government when it was seeking an exemption to this appalling policy. When it comes to the number of sharks being caught, as I said, it's been left up to the community to rely on media reports and observation that's being undertaken on the water, and also the Surf Life Saving WA, which is tweeting when they know a shark has been released off a beach. The state government has a responsibility to report this information to the community and certainly to the federal government, and I'm wondering how much of this information the federal government already knows, or is it also relying on media reports to find out what its exemption has done to these sharks. We also don't know anything about any of the other marine life that has been affected by these drumlines, because we know that drumlines also affect other marine life. Let me be clear, while this is a WA policy, it would not have gone ahead without the exemption of the federal government, without the complicity of the Minister for the Environment, Mr Hunt, because he gave an exemption to this program. If it hadn't have been for that exemption, this policy would have been at least assessed. So West Australians hold the federal government, Mr Hunt and Mr Abbott, just as complicit and responsible for this cull policy, because this is what it is, make no mistake. This is culling sharks. They are just as responsible, the federal government is just as responsible as the state government. The exemption allows the killing of tiger sharks, bull sharks and great white sharks over 3 metres and was signed by the Minister for the Environment on the 10th of January, although West Australians didn't find out about this until some time later. The exemption granted by Mr Hunt does not allow the killing of sharks that are under 3 metres in length, but it is clear that the drum lines are in fact catching and harming sharks outside their supposed target size, in other words, over 3 metres. They are, as I outlined, the vast majority of things that have, or species and animals that have been caught on these drum lines are in fact not the target species, they're under 3 metres, and we don't know what long-term impact it's having on the actual sharks caught, but also on the marine ecosystem. The Department of Premier and Cabinet in Western Australia today has confirmed that sharks caught on drum lines are being attacked both in the southwest and off Perth. They've not said how many sharks have shown these signs of attack, but there's at least 2 have been reported. The WA government has said only that these incidents are in a minority. This lack of detail is yet another example of where the government is avoiding scrutiny of this policy. Sharks that are being caught and then released from drum lines can sustain potentially life-threatening injuries through the hooks themselves and while they're waiting to be released, because the lines aren't being checked 24/7. And this, of course, adds to the potential for attacks from other sharks and other predators. And we simply don't know how many sharks are dying once they have been released from the drum lines. The RSPCA has raised their concerns about the difficulties of killing large sharks humanely and have questioned whether the contracted fishermen involved in this process have the necessary expertise. The federal minister, Minister Hunt, needs to look into these issues immediately. Sharks play a critical role in the health and well-being of our oceans ecosystems. They are an apex predator, and West Australians know this, and that's why they're responding, much to Mr Barnett's surprise, I bet, that's why they're responding to this appalling policy. This cull policy is being condemned by West Australians. It's being condemned by people who care about the marine environment and care for sharks around the planet. People around the planet and West Australians know that sharks are essential to maintaining the balance of our ecosystems and allowing populations of other creatures to remain at a healthy level. Great white sharks are a protected species. They are a vulnerable species listed under the Environmental Protection and Biodiversity Conservation Act. The federal government and the Minister for the Environment has a responsibility, or should I say had a responsibility, because he's exempted himself from that responsibility, to look after these sharks, to look after the other marine species that are being caught by this appalling policy. He granted an exemption on conditions, a number of conditions, and one of those was that they would use hooks that were a size enough so that they would minimise the environmental impact, so they would minimise the number or cause at least harm as possible to smaller sharks. That is not what's happening, because the vast majority of the sharks that are being taken on these drum lines are under 3 metres. They are not meeting that condition. Clause 23 of the exemption says that if they're not meeting the conditions outlined in paragraph 17, of which one of the conditions I just outlined, that the policy should be reviewed or it could be revoked. This policy should be revoked immediately. It is harming our marine ecosystems. It is harming sharks. It has no place in the management of a marine ecosystem. But I suppose we shouldn't be surprised, given that it's the Abbott government that essentially suspended our world-leading national system of marine protected areas. By suspending the management plans, as this place rose last December, in secrecy again, he's essentially abandoned the marine protected area system. It is basically now lines on maps. So what else should I expect really from the federal government other than to wash their hands of the need to protect a vulnerable species? The great white shark is a vulnerable species. The government has not relied on science on this. It's a knee-jerk reaction. The exemption should be revoked. The cull should be abandoned because it is not achieving what the Barnett government wanted to achieve. It is taking undersized sharks. It has led to the death of four tiger sharks.
Time has expired, Senator Seward.